طيب الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد. We praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى and we ask Allah to exalt the mention and grant peace to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. In our last session, session number 4 of Aqeedah Al-Waasitiyyah, we had stopped at the breakdown of what are the matters or what are the evidences that we use to prove the existence of Allah جل جلاله وتقدست أسماؤه. Today we will be discussing in detail what do Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe regarding Al Malaika. So the Shaykh said wa malaikatuhu al malaikatu jam' mal'ak wa aslu mal'ak ma'lak li'annahu min al aluka wal aluka fi al lugha al risala. Now very technical, obviously malaika is the plural of mal'ak. And mal'ak originally comes from the word ma'lak. So it's either that the hamza is on the laf, on the lam, or the hamza is on the alif. لِأَنَّهُ مِنَ الْأَلُوكَ, because it comes from the word aluka, and aluka في اللغة الرسالة means message. So the actual meaning of mala'ika is technically messengers. قال الله تعالى جَاعِلِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ رُسُولًا أُولِي أَجْنِحَةٍ مَثْنَا, until the end of the ayah. Surah Fatir, ayah number 1. He made the angels messengers possessing wins and twos and fours and so on and so forth. مَثْنَ وَثُلَثَ وَرُبَعَ. So the malaika, actually the root word from a linguistic point of view comes from messenger. فَالْمَلَائِكَةُ عَالَمٌ غَيْبِي. So the angels is from the world of the unseen. خَلَقَهُمُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مِن نُورٍ. Allah Azza wa Jal created them from light. وَجَعَلَهُمْ طَائِعِينَ لَهُ مُتَذَلِّلِينَ لَهُ. And Allah Azza wa Jal made them obedient to Him and in the state of subservience to Him at all time. وَلِكُلِّ مِّنْهُمْ وَظَائِفْ خَصَّهُ اللَّهُ بِهَا. And to each of them, there are duties which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assigned to them. They all have a job that Allah Azza wa Jal assigned to them. وَنَعْلَمُ مِنْ وَظَائِفِهِمْ. Among the ones that we know, among the functions that we know, أولاً جبريل. جبريل عليه السلام مُوَكَّلٌ بِالْوَحِي. He is the one who's entrusted with revelation. He is the one who's entrusted with divine revelation. يَنْزِلُ بِهِ مِنَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى إِلَى الرَّسُولِ. He descends from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the messengers. ثانياً إسرافيل مُوَكَّلٌ بِنَفْخِ الصُّورِ. Israfil is the one who's assigned for blowing the trumpet on the last day. وَهُوَ أَيْضًا أَحَدُ حَمَلَةِ الْعَرْشِ. And he is also among those angels that are the bearers of the throne of Allah, among those who carry the throne of Allah جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ. ثَالِثًا مِيكَائِيل مُوَكَّلٌ بِالْقَطْرِ وَالنَّبَاتِ. And the third one is Mikail, who's entrusted with rain and with plantation. Mikail, who's entrusted with water and rainfall and plantation. وَهَؤُلَاءِ الثَّلَاثَةِ كُلُّهُمْ مُوَكَّلُونَ بِمَا فِيهِ حَيَاتِ. All of these three are actually assigned with something that has to do with life. Something that has to do with bringing life. فَجِبْرِيلُ مُوَكَّلٌ بِالْوَحِي وَفِي حَيَاةِ الْقُلُوبِ. Jibreel is assigned with wahi, revelation, and that brings life to the heart. وَمِيكَائِيل بِالْقَطْرِ وَالنَّبَاتِ وَفِي حَيَاةِ الْأَرْضِ. And Mikail is assigned for waterfall and vegetation and plantation, and that has the life for the earth. وَإِسْرَافِيل بِنَفْخِ الصُّورِ وَفِي حَيَاةُ الْأَسْوَادِ يَوْمَ الْمِيعَادِ. And Israfil is assigned for the blowing of the trumpet, and in that there's life in the bodies when they are resurrected on the day of the promised day. وَلِهَذَا كَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَتَوَسَّلُ بِرُوبِيَّةِ اللَّهِ لَهُمْ فِي دُعَاءِ الْاِسْتِفْتَاحِ فِي صَلَاةِ اللَّيْلِ. This is why the Prophet صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ used to beg Allah. He used to beg Allah in his lordship to those angels in his opening dua of the night prayer. And he would say, فَيَقُولُ اللَّهُمَّ رب جبرائيل وميكائيل وإسرافيل. Oh Allah, the Lord of Jibreel and Mikail wa Israfil, فاطر السماوات والأرض. You are the producer, the maker of the heavens and the earth. عالم الغيب والشهادة. You are the knower of the seen and the unseen. So Allah Azza wa Jal is the originator of the heavens and the earth, the knower of the seen and the unseen. أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون. You are the one who will judge between your servants concerning that which they used to differ on. اهديني لما اختلف فيه بين الحق بإذنك. Guide me to that which they have differed about. Guide me to the truth regarding that by your permission. إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. Verily you guide whomsoever you will to the straight path. هذا الدعاء الذي كان يقوله في قيام الليل متوسلا بربوبية الله لهم. This was the dua the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make at night when he would pray. And this is the dua that you should make before in the beginning of ركعة الوتر. When you pray witr, brothers and sisters, this is the dua that you should make in istiftah for ركعة الوتر. Whether you're praying one or three or even five. The first rak'ah, you, if they're going to be connected, of course, you begin with this particular dua. How many of us do that? Allahu Ta'ala a'lam. كذلك نعلم أن منهم من وكل بقبض أرواح بني آدم. We also know that among the angels are those who have been assigned to take the souls of the children of Adam. So those who are assigned to take away with the souls of the children of Adam. أو يقبض روح كل ذي روح, or to even take the soul of any soul possessor. وهم ملك الموت وأعوانه. Who are them? Who are those? It is the angel of death and his assistants. ولا يسمى عزرائيل, and we don't call him عزرائيل. By the way, عزرائيل is a very common name for the angel of death in the Middle East. In the Middle East and maybe in many other regions of the world. That name is inauthentic. And therefore the angel of death should be called, as Allah called him in the Quran, Malakul Maut. His name is not Azrail. لأنه لم يثبت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن اسمه هذا. It has not been established authentically from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that this is his name. قال تعالى حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت توفته رسلنا وهم لا يفرطون. Allah says until when death approaches one of them, أحدكم عفوا حتى إذا جاء أحدكم الموت, نعم, until death approaches one of you, our messengers take a soul and they will never neglect their duty. وقال تعالى قل يتوفاكم ملك الموت الذي وكل بكم. Say the angel of death who's been set over you will take away your souls. وقال تعالى الله يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها. Allah عز وجل further said it is Allah who takes away the souls at the time of their death. ولا منافاة بين هذه الآيات الثلاثة. There is no contradiction between these three آيات. فإن الملائكة تقبض الروح. The angels take the soul. فإن ملك الموت إذا أخرجها من البدن تكون عنده ملائكة. So when the angel of death takes the soul from the body, he will have with them the angels. إذا كان الرجل من أهل الجنة, if the person is from the people of Jannah, فيكون معهم حنوط من الجنة, they will have a perfume from Jannah, وكفن من الجنة, and they will have a shroud from Jannah. يأخذون هذه الروح الطيبة, they will take this blessed or this righteous soul, ويجعلونها في هذا الكفن, and they will shroud it in the shroud, ويصعدون بها إلى الله عز وجل, and they will ascend therein to Allah عز وجل, حتى تقف بين يد الله, until it is placed between the two hands of Allah. ثم يقول اكتبوا كتاب عبدي في عليين. Allah عز وجل will then say write the book of my slave in عليين, وأعيدوه إلى الأرض, and return him to the earth, فترجع الروح إلى الجسد من أجل الاختبار. Then the soul will be returned back to the body in order to be tested. من ربك وما دينك ومن نبيك. Who is your Lord? Who is your Deen? And who is your Prophet? وإذا كان الميت غير مؤمن والعياذ بالله. If the person who died is not a believer and we seek refuge with Allah, فإنه ينزل ملائكة معهم كفن من نار وحنوط من نار. Then the angels will come and they will have a shroud from the fire. They will have a shroud that is made from the fire and a stench that comes from the fire. يأخذون الروح, they will take the soul, ويجعلونها في هذا الكفن, and they will place it in that shroud. ثم يصعدون بها إلى السماء, then they will try to ascend in the sky. فَتُغْلَقُ أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاءِ دُونَهَا. Then the gates of paradise will be closed. وَتُطْرَحْ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ, and it will be thrown back to earth. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, Allah says, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَكَأَنَّمَا خَرَّ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَتَخْطَفُهُ الطَّيْرُ أَوْ تَهْوِي بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي مَكَانٍ صَحِيقٍ. And whosoever associates partners with Allah, it is as though he has fallen from the sky, and then the birds will snatch him and the wind will throw him in a very far place. Yeah, brother, turn off your video, barakallah feek. Brother, please turn off your video. Faisal. Okay, Faisal. I had to do it myself. Jazakallah khair. طيب. ثم يقول الله اكتب كتاب عبدي في سجين نسأل الله العافية. Then Allah Azza wa Jal will say, write the book of my, write the record of my servant in سجين. May Allah Azza wa Jal protect us. طيب. هؤلاء موكلون بقبض الروح من ملك الموت إذا قبضها. وملك الموت هو الذي يباشر قبضها. فلا منافاة إذن. So those angels that take away the soul, they take it from the angel of death after he takes the soul. So the angel of death is the first one, Malakul Maut, he takes the soul from the body, and then the angels, the assistant angels, will take it from him, and there's absolutely no contradiction between those. لا منافات إذن. والذي يأمر بذلك هو الله. And the one who commands that to begin with is Allah Azza wa Jal. فيكون في الحقيقة هو المتوفي. So it is Allah Azza wa Jal, in essence, the one who causes death. Because it is by the command of Allah only that a person's die. وَمِنْهُمْ مَلَائِكَةٌ سَيَّحُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And among them are angels that travel around on the earth. يَلْتَمِسُونَ حِلَقَ الذِّكْرِ. They are searching and they search for the places of remembrance, the gatherings of remembrance of Allah. إِذَا وَجَدُوا حَلَقَةِ الْعِلْمِ وَالذِّكْرِ جَلَسُوا. Whenever they find a gathering where there's knowledge and remembrance, they will sit down. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us among them, and that the angels will be among us. وَكَذَلِكَ هُنَالِكَ مَلَائِكَةٌ يَكْتُبُونَ أَعْمَالِ الْإِنسَانِ. Similarly, there are angels that are assigned to write the deeds of people. Allah says, وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفَعَلُونَ. But verily, over you are appointed angels in charge of mankind. This is between parentheses, to watch you. They are honorable, writing down your deeds, and they know all that which you do. In another ayah, Allah says, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Not a word does he or she utter, but there's a watcher by him ready to record it. So anything that we say is being recorded either for us or against us. This is why you should listen to this story. دخل أحد أصحاب الإمام أحمد عليه الإمام أحمد وهو عليه وهو مريض رحمه الله. One of the friends or one of the companions of Imam Ahmad entered upon him while he was sick, and he saw that he فوجده يئن من المرض. He saw that he was groaning from illness. فقال له يا أبا عبد الله. He said to him, Oh father of Abdullah, يا أبا عبد الله, تئن, are you groaning? وقد قال طاووس, and طاووس was one of the scholars, إن الملك يكتب حتى أنين المريض, that the angel will even write the groaning of the ill person. The angel writes down everything, even the groan of a sick person. And then he recited the ayah, لأن كل شيء يكتب. فجعل أب أيوة لأن الله يقول ما يلفظ من قول إن لديه رقيب عتيد. He does not utter, or she does not utter a word except that there's an angel that is writing down, ready, a watcher ready writing down. فجعل أبو عبد الله أبو عبد الله يتصبر. So then Abu Abdullah started to exercise patience. وترك الأنين, and he left groaning. Look how they used to be. You know, a simple advice. Once you cite the Quran, immediate submission, immediate compliance. Now you tell the brother, Allah says in the Quran, and you cite 10 ayat, and the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, and you cite 20 narrations, and you tell him the salaf, then he tells you, yeah, yeah, but my sheikh said, your sheikh said a lot of stuff, Allah yahdik wa yahdi sheikhak. أي طيب لأن كل شيء يكتب ما يلفظ من قول من زائد لتوكيد العموم. Anyways from a linguistic point of view this من قول ما يلفظ من قول من necessitates generality everything it's encompassing أي أي قول تقوله يكتب any word you say will be written and it doesn't mean that if you type it it's not لكن قد تجازى عليه بخير أو شر هذا حسب القول الذي قيل however you could be rewarded with good or you could be rewarded with evil that depends on what you have actually said ومنهم أيضا ملائكة يتعاقبون على بني آدم في الليل والنهار and also among them are angels that they are angels that constantly يتعاقبون they take turns upon Bani Adam in the morning and in the night. So they basically succeed one another in staying with human beings. Allah says, لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِ يَحْفَظُونَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ For each person, there are angels in succession, before and behind him. They guard him by the command of Allah. وَمِنْهُمْ مَلَائِكَةٌ رُكَّعٌ وَسُجَّدٌ لِلَّهِ فِي السَّمَاءِ And among them are angels that are in the state of bowing and prostration to Allah in the heavens. قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَطَّتِ السَّمَاءِ وَحُقَّ لَهَا أَنْ طَئِطْ The heavens is creaking. The heaven has a sound of creaking and it has every right to creak. وَالْأَطِيطْ صَرِيرُ الرُّحَلْ الرحل is the saddle that you put on the camel. So whenever you put a load on the camel, it has the sound. أي إذا كان على البعير حمل ثقيل تسمع له صرير مثل ثقل الحمل. So whenever you have some heavy load on the camel, you will hear like a creaking sound. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is making that analogy and that comparison. Any type of heavy load that will create this creaking sound on the camel, then this is similar. The heaven creak and it has every right to creak. Why? أطت سما وحق لها أن طأت ما من موضع أربع أصابع منها إلا وفيه ملك قائم لله أو راكع أو ساجد. There is no place that could contain four fingers. There is no place that could contain four fingers in the heaven except that there's an angel standing, bowing or prostrating to Allah therein. Imagine, وَعَلَى سِعَةِ السَّمَاءِ فِيهَا هَؤُلَاءِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ In spite of the vastness of the heavens, there are that many angels in a perpetual state of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِهَذَا قَالَ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فِي الْبَيْتِ الْمَعْمُورِ الذي مر به في ليلة المعراج. That's why the Prophet ﷺ spoke about the oft frequented house, which is in the heavens, when he was taken up on the ascension. قال يطوف به أو قال يدخله. Whether that place is circumambulated or whether they enter it. 70,000 ملك كل يوم. 70,000 angels enter every day. ثم لا يعودون إليه آخر ما عليهم. And then they never go back again. 70,000 angels enter every day. والمعنى كل يوم يأتي إليه 70,000 ملك غير الذين أتوه بالأمس. Every day 70,000 angels, new ones, will enter other than the ones that came the day before. ولا يعودون له أبدا and they never return therein. يأتي ملائكة آخرون غير من سبق. New angels other than the ones preceded them will come. وهذا يدل على كثرة الملائكة. This is indicative of how huge the number of malaika is. There's a humongous number of malaika. وَلِهَذَا قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّهُ And that's why Allah Azza wa Jal says, and no one knows the soldiers of your Lord but He. وَمِنْهُمْ مَلَائِكَةٌ مُوَكَّلُونَ بِالْجَنَّةِ وَمُوَكَّلُونَ بِالنَّارِ And among them are angels that are assigned for Jannah and others that are assigned for the hellfire. فَخَازِنُ النَّارِ اسْمُهُ مَالِكٌ The guardian of the hellfire والعياذ بالله his name is Malik. يقول أهل النار يا مالك ليقضي علينا ربك. They will say, Oh Malik, let your Lord destroy us. Let your Lord, annihilate us. We don't want to exist anymore. This is in Surah Az-Zukhruf. يعني ليهلكنا ويمتنا. Let him destroy us and cause us to die. فهم يدعون الله أن يميتهم. They're asking Allah to cause them to die لأنهم في عذاب لا يصبر يصبر عليه. Because they are going through a torment that you can't be patient. You don't have enough patience to bear. فيقول إنكم ماكثون. He will say to them, rather you shall stay and abide forever. We seek refuge with Allah on this blessed day, in this Ramadan, so that none of us will ever hear this statement. We will never say, we'll never have to say this, and we will never hear it. بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ الله المستعان. وَمِنْهُمْ مَلَائِكَةٌ نَعْمٌ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِثُونَ ثُمَّ يُقَالُ لَهُمْ لَقَدْ جِئْنَاكُمْ بِالْحَقِّ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَكُمْ لِلْحَقِّ كَارِهُونَ. Be careful, my brothers and sisters, from this. It will be said to them, indeed we have brought the truth to you, but most of you have a hatred for the truth. And wallahi, this is a sickness that the ummah is suffering from. Until now, we have the same disease. People reject the truth, even though the truth is right there in their face and evident. Listen to my lecture on Sufism. And listen to my lecture, The Horn of Satan, on Wahhabism. Listen to the evidences from the Quran and the Sunnah. Listen to the truth being conveyed, and then read the comments of the people. Read the comments of the people. As soon as they see the lecture, يأخي, within a minute before he even hears, he leaves a comment. Wahhabi, Takfiri, Khariji, Kafir, dog, and other words. Before he even reads, before he even hears, before he even understands. This is the sheep among them. Their leaders, they know, they hear, but they don't hear. They hear the truth, but they don't hear, they don't conform. And the number one reason these people will be in the hellfire, asking to be destroyed, it will be said to them, we brought the truth to you, but most of you used to hate the truth. So we all have to be careful. What aspect of the religion that is truthful that we have a problem with, it's a sign of the heart not being sound, brothers and sisters. We need to fix that problem. We should love the truth, because it comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if we struggle to implement it because of weakness, we should still love it. And when we're unable to fulfill it, we say, we have a problem, we have a shortcoming. Not that we change the religion according to our shortcomings. المهم أنه يجب علينا أن نؤمن بالملائكة. The Sheikh said, the bottom line is that it is important that we believe in the angels. طيب. وكيف الإيمان بالملائكة? How do we believe in angels? نؤمن بأنهم عالم غيبي لا يشاهدون. First, we believe that they are from the world of the unseen and they cannot be seen. وقد يشاهدون. And there are exceptions where they might be seen. إنما الأصل أنهم عالم غيبي. But the fundamental principle is that they are from the unseen. مخلوقون من نور. They are created from light. مكلفون بما كلفهم الله به من العبادات. They are assigned with whatever functions and duties Allah gave them in terms of worship. وهم خاضعون لله عز وجل أتم الخضوع. And they are in a complete state of subservience to Allah. They are completely subservient to Allah. لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. They never disobey Allah concerning the commands He gives them, and they do everything that they are commanded. كذلك نؤمن بأسماء من علمنا بأسمائهم. Just like we believe that they're created from light, and that they're from the unseen, and that they are obedient to Allah, and that they have tasks, we also believe whatever names we have that has been given to us through revelation, Quran and Sunnah. ونؤمن بوظائف من علمنا بوظائفهم. Similarly, we believe in the functions of those whom we have been given information about their functions. ويجب علينا أن نؤمن بذلك على ما علمنا. And we must then believe based on what we have been taught and based on the information which we have been given. كذلك نعم وهم أشاد. And it's important to believe that they have actual bodies. We believe that they have actual bodies. بدليل قوله تعالى جاعل الملائكة رسلا أولي أجنحة. That Allah عز وجل made the angels messengers possessing wings. ورأى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جبريل على صورته التي خلق عليها له 600 جناح. the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw Jibreel. He saw Jibreel in his original form, and he had 600 wings. He had 600 wings. قَدْ سَدَّ الْأُفُقْ. He had completely blocked the whole horizon. He completely covered up the whole sky. خِلَافًا لِمَنْ قَالْ إِنَّهُمْ أَرْوَحٌ. So we believe they are physical beings. They are not merely spirits. This is in refutation to those who claim that the angels are merely spirits. We believe that the angels have physical bodies because of the evidence and because of the fact that Prophet ﷺ saw Jibreel in his physical form and he had 600 wings and he covered the entire sky. إِذَا قَالَ قَائِلٌ. If a person asks, هَلْ لَهُمْ عُقُولٌ. Do they have intellect? نقول هل لك عقل. We say, do you have any intellect? ما يسأل عن هذا إلا رجل مجنون. No one asks this question except an insane person, except someone who's crazy. فقد قال الله تعالى لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. They don't. Allah said they don't disobey Allah concerning the commands and they do what they're commanded. فهل يثني عليهم هذا الثناء وليس لهم عقول. Would Allah praise them if they had no intellect? If they had no intellect, then there's nothing praiseworthy if they do what they're told and they don't disobey. There's nothing special about that. That's an expectation. أنا أقول هؤلاء ليس لهم عقول. Can we say, oh, another ayah Allah Azza wa Jal says, يسبحون الليل والنهار لا يفترون. لا يفترون, عفوا. يسبحون الليل والنهار لا يفترون. They glorify the remembrance of Allah in the night and the day and they do not slack. They do not slack in doing so. نقول هؤلاء ليس لهم عقول. Can we say afterwards these don't have any intellect. يأتمرون بأمر الله. They are obeying and following the command of Allah. ويفعلون ما أمر الله به. And they're doing what Allah عز وجل commanded. ويبلغون الوحي. And they convey the revelation. ونقول ليس لهم عقول. And then we come after all this and say that they don't have any intellect. أحق من يوصف بعدم العقل من قال إنه لا عقول لهم. The one who deserves to be described as having no intellect is the one who claims that they have no intellect. طيب. So that concludes the discussion on the Malaika. And I hope that it is clear and straightforward. Inshallah, there is no confusion there. طيب. Next, we're going to move to the Kutub. Kutub is the plural of kitab. وَكُتُبِهِ أَيْ كُتُبِ اللَّهِ الَّتِي أَنْزَلَهَا مَعَ الرُّسُلِ. So we believe in the books, or if you want to use the term scriptures, that's not an issue right now. Both are applicable. We believe in the books that Allah Azza wa Jal send down upon the messengers. وَلِكُلِّ رَسُولٍ كِتَابٍ. Every messenger has a book. قال الله تعالى لقد أرسلنا رسولنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان. Indeed, we have sent our messengers with clear proofs and revealed with them the book and the balance. وهذا يدل على أن كل رسول معه كتاب. This is an evidence that every messenger has a prophet. Every messenger has a book. لكن لا نعرف كل الكتب. However, we don't know all the books. بل نعرف منها, the ones we know of them. صحف إبراهيم وموسى, the scriptures of Ibrahim and Musa. والتوراة, we know the Torah. الإنجيل, the Injil, which is known as the Gospel. والزبور, the Psalms of the Psalms. والقرآن, and the Book of Allah, the Quran. ستة, we know six. لأن صحف موسى بعضهم يقول هي التوراة. Some of them say the scriptures of Musa are also the Torah. وبعضهم يقول غيرها. And some of them say, no, it's another book other than the Torah. So they say that Musa had the Torah and the Suhuf of Musa, which are mentioned in the end of Surah Al-A'la. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَفِي الصُّحُفِ الْأُولَى صُحُفِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ أي وَمُوسَى. نعم. فَإِنْ كَانَتِ التَّوْرَةَ فَهِيَ خَمْسَةَ. So if the Torah is included, they become five. If the Torah are the Suhuf of Musa, then they are five. وَإِنْ كَانَتْ غَيْرَهَا فَهِيَ سِتَّةَ. However, if they are two distinct revelations or scriptures, then we have six. وَلَكِنْ مَعَ ذَلِكَ نَحْنُ نُؤْمِنْ بِكُلِّ كِتَابٍ أَنْزَلَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى الرُّسُلِ وَإِنْ لَمْ نَعْلَمْ بِهِ نُؤْمِنُ بِهِ إِجْمَالًا. However, we believe in every book that Allah
revealed to the messengers, even if we don't know about it, we just believe in it in its totality. We believe in it in its totality as a whole. طيب ورسله أي رسل الله وهم الذين أوحى الله إليهم بالشرائع وأمرهم بتبليغها وأولهم نوح وآخرهم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And we believe in the messengers, i.e. the messengers of Allah. And it is those whom Allah Azza wa Jal revealed to them the legislation. And He commanded them to convey it to the people. The first of which was Nuh, and the last is our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الدليل على أن أولهم نوح. The evidence that Nuh was the first messenger. قوله تعالى إن قوله تعالى إن أوحينا إليك كما أوحينا إلى نوح والنبيين من بعده. Allah said in the Quran in Surah An-Nisa, verily we have inspired you as we inspired Nuh and the prophets after him. يعني وحيا كإيحائنا إلى نوح والنبيين من بعده. Meaning we're giving you an inspiration similar to the one we gave Nuh and the prophets after him. وهو وحي الرسالة. And it is that specific inspiration of the messengership. وقوله ولقد أرسلنا نوحا وإبراهيم وجعلنا في ذريتهما النبوة والكتاب. Allah further says, and indeed we have sent Noah and Abraham and placed in their offspring prophethood and scripture. في ذريتهما أي ذرية نوح وإبراهيم, meaning in the ذرية of نوح and Ibrahim, in their offspring. والذي قبل نوح لا يكون من ذريته. Whoever came before نوح cannot possibly be from his offspring. The person or the prophet who came before نوح cannot possibly be from his offspring. Obviously he has to be after him. وكذلك قوله تعالى وقوم نوح من قبل إنهم كانوا قوما فاسقين. Allah further says, and so were the people of Nuh before them, verily they were a people who were rebellious and disobedient. قد نقول إن قوله من قبل يدل على ما سبق. So we could say that من قبل refers to that which preceded him. إذن من القرآن ثلاثة أدلة إذا من القرآن ثلاثة أدلة تدل على أن نوحا أول الرسل. So from the Quran we have three evidences that suggest that Nuh was the first messenger. وَمِنَ السُّنَّةِ مَا ثَبَتَ فِي حَدِيثِ الشَّفَاعَةِ. We have supporting evidence to reinforce this position from the Sunnah in the hadith of intercession. أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْمَوْقِفِ يَقُولُونَ لِنُوحَ أَنْتَ أَوَّلَ رَسُولٌ أَرْسَلَهُ اللَّهُ لِأَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ. The people will say to Nuh on the day of judgment, after they have been waiting for 50,000 years in the heat, they will say to Nuh, you are the first messenger whom Allah has sent to the people of earth. وهذا صريح, and this is very straightforward. أما آدم عليه الصلاة والسلام فهو نبي وليس برسول. As for Adam, he is a prophet and not a messenger. That's why the belief of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah is that Adam was the first prophet and Nuh was the first messenger, and that Adam was not a messenger. And as we've said in the past, every messenger is a prophet, but not every prophet is a messenger. Again, every messenger is a prophet. For you to be a messenger, it's this advanced level, you have to be a prophet first. But not every prophet is advanced to the level of being a messenger. So you could say every doctor was a student, because you couldn't have become a doctor if you weren't a student, but not every student is a doctor, because the person might learn and then, fail and flunk the class and never make it. So now, أما نعم وأما إدريس فذهب كثير من المؤرخين أو أكثرهم من المؤرخين أو أكثرهم وبعض المفسرين أيضا إن إلى أنه قبل نوح. As for Idrees, which is mentioned in the Quran, some of the historians and some of the مفسرين, in fact the majority of the historians and some of the مفسرين, they said that he was before نوح and that he's from the grandfathers of نوح وأنه من أجدادي. لكن هذا قول ضعيف جدا, but that is a very weak position. والقرآن والسنة ترده. And the Quran and the Sunnah reject that position. والصواب ما ذكرنا, and the correct position is what we mentioned previously, that Idrees did not come before Nuh. وآخرهم محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام, and the last of them is Muhammad عليه, may Allah exalt his mention and grant him peace. لِقَوْلِ تَعَالَى وَلَكِنْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. Because Allah says about him, rather, he is the messenger of Allah, he is the messenger of Allah and the last of the prophets, or the seal of the prophets. وَلَمْ يَقُلْ وَخَاتَمَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Allah did not say he's the seal of the messengers. لأنه إذا ختم النبوة ختم الرسالة من باب أولى. Because if he is the last prophet, then by default he is the last messenger. Because we already said that you cannot be a messenger if you're not a prophet first. So if he is the last prophet, there's no way there's going to be a messenger who's not a prophet. So subhanAllah, it's very clear. فإن قلت عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام ينزل في آخر الزمان وهو رسول فما الجواب. If you say, طيب, عيسى will come back at the end of time and he is a messenger. So how do we answer this question or this dilemma? نقول هو لا ينزل بشريعة جديدة وإنما يحكم بشريعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. First we say he's not going to be given a new legislation, rather he will rule by the legislation of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فإذا قال قائل من المتفق عليه أن خير هذه الأمة بعد نبيها أبو بكر. It has been agreed that the best people after this ummah is the best in this ummah after its prophet is Abu Bakr. وعيسى يحكم بشريعة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام فيكون من أتباع. And if Jesus is going to rule and govern by the same legislation of the prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, therefore that makes him from his followers. فكيف يصح قولنا إن خير هذه الأمة بعد نبيها أبو بكر. How is it correct that we say the best of this ummah after the prophet, after its prophet, meaning the Prophet Muhammad, is Abu Bakr? فالجواب أحد ثلاثة وجوه. أولها أن عيسى عليه الصلاة والسلام رسول مستقل من أولي العزم. The first answer to this issue is, عيسى is an independent messenger from those of strong determination. ولا يخطر بالبال بالمقارنة بينه وبين واحد من هذه الأمة. No one even thinks to compare, make a comparison between Jesus and between a person of this ummah. فكيف بالمفاضلة. We don't compare, let alone to say one is better than the other. وعلى هذا يسقط هذا الإيراد من أصله. This whole presentation is bogus and foundationless from the beginning. لأنه من التنطع. Because it's a form of you trying to be very particular and you trying to be very difficult. Actually, it's a form of difficulty. تنطع is when you're extreme. And it reminds me of one of these clowns on Facebook. I don't want to mention his name because he doesn't deserve any advertisement. But he has all types of fishy posts. And subhanAllah, almost a week ago, I came across the same post trying to claim that Isa is better and is the best sahabi to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam instead of Abu Bakr. And no one says something like this except someone that has some Shia sickness in his heart. Anyone who takes a swipe at Abu Bakr Siddiq, even if he's doing so by making Jesus better than him, has a sickness in his heart and some sort of ideology of Shiism. Because a Sunni does not even think in this form. We don't even strike this comparison to try to claim that Isa is better than Abu Bakr. Why are you trying to belittle the position of Abu Bakr? Why? Who from the Salaf preceded you in this? Except you and this funny sheikh of yours. The same people that tell you that worship has a different meaning and you only consider to be worshipping something if you believe that it is Allah and it has Allah's attributes. So therefore all the shirk that the ummah does right now, they don't consider this to be shirk at all. But they can put pictures of people that are half naked, no problem. MashaAllah, taqwa is at the highest degree. Yani those people, man, may Allah Azza wa Jal shut down their Facebook accounts and shut down their communication with the world, because the corruption that they spread and the evil that they spread is so bad. And most Muslims are gullible and vulnerable. They don't know, they don't learn, they don't distinguish, they don't differentiate. They believe that people say, oh, mashallah, brother, very nice post. Wallah, I never thought of it this way. There's a reason you never thought of it this way, because the Sahaba, because the scholars don't speak this way. That's why you didn't think about it. But now people are putting ideas in your mind. Huh? Hey. Anyways, this is a form of extremism. أثنى نقول هو خير الأمة إلا عيسى. We say he's the best of this ummah except Isa. الثالث أن نقول إن عيسى ليس من الأمة. The third answer is to say عيسى is not even of the Ummah of the Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام. ولا يصح أن نقول إنه من أمته. Nor can we say, nor is it correct to say that he is from the followers of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهو سابق عليه, because he preceded him. لكنه من أتباعي إذا نزل. However, he will follow when he comes back, when he descends. لأن شريعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم باقية يوم القيامة. Because the legislation of the Prophet will remain until the end of time. فإن قال قائل كيف يكون تابعا وهو يقتل الخنزير. If someone says how is he a follower yet he will kill the pig ويكسر الصليب and he will break the cross ولا يقبل إلا الإسلام مع أن الإسلام يقر أهل الكتاب بالجزية and he will not accept anything except Islam even though Islam allows the people of the book to pay the taxes to pay the jizya. قلنا إخبار النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بذلك إقرار له فتكون من شرعه ويكون نسخا لما سبق من حكم الإسلام الأول. We say the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم telling us about that is a form of approving. So it becomes part of his legislation. So that will abrogate the previous rule in Islam. The current rule in Islam is that you don't go to the Christians and you slaughter their pigs and you break their crosses. You let them as is, and they pay the jizya if they are living under the Islamic rulership. However, at the end of time, Isa will do something else, and that is approved by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam because he's the one who told us about it. Hey, so I hope it's clear. نعم والبعث بعد الموت and resurrection after death. البعث بمعنى الإخراج. بعث is when you take something out. It's a form of taking something out. نعم. Where was I? A. فتكون نعم. يعني إخراج الناس من قبورهم عفوا بعد موتهم. So we are speaking about people being taken out from their graves after their deaths. People being taken out, bringing the people out from their graves after their death. So بعث is like a resurrection. Huh? بعث is resurrection. وهذا من معتقد أهل السنة والجماعة. And this is from the belief of أهل السنة والجماعة. وهذا ثابت بالكتاب والسنة وإجماع المسلمين. And this is confirmed as per the Quran and the Sunnah and the consensus of the Muslims. بل إجماع اليهود والنصارى. Rather even a consensus with the Jews and the Christians. Huh? حيث يقرون بأن هنالك يوما يبعث الناس فيه ويجازون. Because they also admit that there will be a day where people will be resurrected and they will be held accountable and recompensed for their deeds. Obviously, the only people that will disagree are the atheists and maybe, you know, I don't know about the Hindus and the Buddhists. But yeah, the Jews and the Muslims and the Christians agree in this sense. أما القرآن فيقول الله عز وجل زعم الذين كفروا أن لن يبعثوا قل بلى وربي لتبعثن. The disbelievers claim that they will never be resurrected for the account. Say, yes, by my Lord, you will certainly be resurrected. وقال عز وجل ثم إنكم بعد ذلك لميتون ثم إنكم يوم القيامة تبعثون. After that, surely you will die. Then surely you'll be resurrected on the day of resurrection. وأما في السنة فجاءت الأحاديث المتواترة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في ذلك. As from the Sunnah, then we have متواتر حديث is overwhelming amount of hadith, يعني narrated by multiple people through multiple chains for a duration where it becomes impossible that it is not from the facts and the matters that are concluded and affirmed in the religion. وأجمع المسلمون على هذا إجماعا قطعيا. So there's a decisive consensus among the Muslims regarding that. وأن الناس سيبعثون يوم القيامة, that mankind will be resurrected on the day of resurrection. ويلاقون ربهم, and they will meet their Lord. ويجازون بأعمالهم, and they will be recompensed for their deeds. فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. So whoever does good equal to the weight of an atom shall see it, and whoever does evil equal to the weight of an atom shall see it. Allah further says, يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَى رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. Allah further says, O man, verily you are returning towards your Lord with your deeds and actions a sure returning. So you will meet him. And kadh means like an effort and struggle. It's not like a picnic. You're going to struggle. فَتَذَكَّرْ هَذَا اللِّقَاءِ The Shaykh said, so always remember this meeting. حَتَّى تَعْمَلْ لَهُ So that you may work for it. خَوْفًا مِنْ أَنْ تَقِفَ بَيْنَ يَدَيِّ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَلَيْسَ عَنْدَكَ شَيْءٍ مِنَ الْعَمَلِ الصَّالِحِ So that you don't stand between the hands of Allah Azza wa Jal on يوم القيامة and you don't have any good deeds to put forward. انظر ماذا عملت ليوم النقلة What have you done for the day of conveyance? وماذا عملت ليوم اللقاء What have you done for the day of meeting? فإن أكثر الناس ينظرون ماذا عملوا للدنيا Most people are busy looking at what they have done for the dunya. ماذا عملوا للدنيا مع العلم بأن هذه الدنيا التي عملوا لها لا يدرون هل يدركونها أم لا Even though this dunya that they're working for, they don't know whether they will make it or not. Yeah, you don't know how long you will make it. قد يخطط الإنسان لعمل دنيوي يفعله غدا أو بعد غد. A person may prepare for a worldly matter that he will do tomorrow or the day after tomorrow. ولكنه لا يدرك غدا ولا بعد غد. However, he will not make it to tomorrow nor the day after. لكن الشيء المتيقن أن أكثر الناس في غفلة من هذا. What we know for sure is that most people are completely heedless and oblivious to this, neglectful of that. قال الله تعالى بل قلوبهم في غمرة من هذا. Allah says, nay, but their hearts are covered, meaning blind from understanding this. وأعمال الدنيا يقول ولهم أعمال من دون ذلك هم لها عاملون. But regarding the matters and the works of the dunya, Allah says, and they have other evil deeds besides which they are doing. وقال تعالى لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا. Verily you were in the state, indeed you were heedless of this. يعني يوم القيامة. فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد. Now we have removed your covering and sharp is your sight this particular day. هذا البعث الذي اتفقت عليه الأديان السماوية وكل متدين بدين هو أحد أركان الإيمان بالستة. This is the resurrection that all of the basically heavenly revealed religions believe in, and it is one of the six pillars of إيمان. وهو من معتقدات أهل السنة والجماعة. It is from the belief of أهل السنة والجماعة. ولا ينكره أحد ممن ينتسب إلى الملة أبدا. No one who claims to be a Muslim has ever denied resurrection. So inshallah ta'ala, we stop at this before we continue next session with the discussion on Qadr. And we'll take your questions if you have any right now, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum, alaikum salam. For much deviant is the belief that only Khadija is the real wife of the Prophet alayhi salam. How to approach refute this? I've never heard of this. How is that possible? How are you gonna deny the ayat in the Quran where Allah says about ummahat al-mu'minin wa azwajuhu ummahatuhum? The wives of Prophet ﷺ are the mothers of the believers. That's how you refute it. Tell them Allah spoke in the plural. Azwajuhu ummahatuhum. His wives are their mothers. So, you're saying only Khadija? Fix that for me, please. And the beginning of Surah Al-Tahrim, Allah spoke about Prophet ﷺ, he kept a secret to some of his wives. Yani, subhanAllah, this is against the Quran. It's actually disbelief. It's a statement of disbelief for someone to deny that Prophet ﷺ married the wives that he married besides Khadija. And it's borderline insanity. Ajeeb Allah. What Aqeedah book should be studied before Wasitiyyah? Kitab al-Tawheed. الثلاثة أصول كشف الشبهات نعم I heard if we pray at home angels pray with us is it authentic I don't know if the angels pray with you but you know we know that angels are around and when the worship is being done they convey that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Allahu alam about them praying with us I'm not familiar with that How did Prophet ﷺ see people in Jannah and Mi'raj?
I mean, the whole incident of Mi'raj is a miracle, akhi. You don't ask how miracles were done. How did Prophet ﷺ ascend? How did he go from Masjid al-Haram to al-Masjid al-Aqsa, alladhi barakna hawla? How did he go in a short span of time back then with no airplanes? And then how did he ascend to the heaven on the mount al-Baraq that he was riding? I mean, it's all a miracle. So we leave it at that. Salaam alaikum, alaikum salam. After we pass away, and from the time the angels come with either fragrant smell or bad one, does the soul know its destination? Yes. Yes. The person will know from the time he's in a grave where he's going to end up. Now, if a person was meant to be from the people of the fire and then Allah Azza wa Jal forgives them, or Allah makes a punishment of the grave, all the punishment that they will get, and when they're resurrected, they go to heaven, this is all from the unseen. Allahu A'lam. But a person will know, because when the soul is taken, if it's a righteous soul, it will be like a droplet of water from the faucet. If it's an evil soul, it will be like snatching metal through wool. The person will know at the moment of death what's going to happen. Hey. In which order those books should be studied? It depends on, ask the ulama. Ask the ulama. They have a sequence. Allahu A'lam. I don't want to give you my opinion. Tayyib. Can we pray Eid al-Fitr at home? Yes, yes. Some of the scholars don't allow it. They say there's no point. But a lot of the scholars, because of the lockdown, because of the predicament, they say, yes, you pray Salatul Eid at home without a khutbah. 7 takbirat in the first rak'ah, and 5 takbirat in the second rak'ah, and done. Yani, it's, you get the reward for it. You have nothing to lose, inshallah. It's definitely not a bid'ah. Whether it is a sunnah or not is what the discussion is. Most of the scholars I've come across in modern day, from the scholars that we take knowledge from, they said, yes, go ahead and pray Salatul Eid at home. Angels of death are unnamed. No, the angel of death, his name is Malakul Maut, the angel of death. The ones, the assistants, no, they're unnamed. And just another question, is there always two angels protecting children? I don't know of two angels protecting children. I don't know of an evidence that says that two angels protect children. Allahu A'lam. I mean, Allahu A'lam. We know that children get hurt anyway, so it's still all under the qadr of Allah Azza wa Jal. We know that there are angels that protect human beings. The number of angels and whether there's a variation between adults and children and elderly, I don't know of any evidence from the Quran and Sunnah that makes that kind of division or that kind of distinction. Tayyib, I think with this we will conclude. We got one question here. I've heard that angels do istighfar for people who are in the circles of knowledge. Does it apply for virtual ones too? Inshallah, of course. Of course, bi'idhnillah azza wa jal. Tayyib, jazakumullah khair. We will have a discussion later amongst each other about when to resume after Eid. And after Ramadan, when is the ideal time, and so on and so forth. We will discuss that on the group and we'll take it from there. Until then, jazakum Allah khair. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe and click on the notification bell. Like, comment, and share with friends and family.